Officials from the Cotton Development Organization, CDO, are seeking parliamentary approval of 9.5 billion shilling supplementary budget for boosting cotton production. Led by William Owachi, the Secretary General of Cotton Development Organization, they told the committee that textile factories are not getting adequate cotton supplies.
It's working in a country like Ethiopia, and it is very, very attractive. Yes, so we believe it's going to bring more investors.
You looked at the incentives of your companies, but now to develop cotton production is not seen in this report.
Part of this supplementary amounting to 7.5 billion shillings was released by the Ministry of Finance to the Cotton Development Organization to enhance the buffer stock revolving fund for fine spinners. Officials explained that Fine Spinners, which is a private company, needed this money to secure cotton lint bales to ensure adequate supply as the current cotton marketing season is coming to an end.
Selling 7.5 billion for revolving cotton buffer stock was received onto the revolving buffer fund bank account and is being used to pay for buffer lint bales with Fine Spinners. Contracts have already been signed and suppliers have started delivery.
Would you kindly tell us, out of these lint exporters, how many companies of these are Ugandans?
However, committee members expressed reservations with another 2 billion shillings that was dished to the same company under the window of 3% supplementary budget, where the government is allowed to spend without prior approval of parliament.
Does it mean the other ones did not knock, they did not seek, they did not ask? What happens?
Transport, that costed 2 billion. And I'm wondering how you do procurement without including the transport and the 2 billion, how it can be accounted for.
Lawmakers questioned the criteria under which the government extended a transport rebate to Fine Spinners and not any other company in the sector.
What was the criteria for these two companies? And we've not met them as a committee. So we demand to meet them and see who they are and see the work they have done with all this budget allocation, a lot of money that has been allocated to them.
It looks like this buffer fund, because it is in line with which they requested it. But when you look at it, it is not a subvention, it is not a subsidy, it is not an incentive.
CDO officials explained that after COVID-19, the cost of production for fine spinners went high due to increased prices of commodities, which affected their competitiveness at the international market. This forced the government to approve their request for a transport rebate.
It means it is expensive, makes their products very expensive now on the international market and less competitive.
However, the committee has not been convinced and resolved to interact with the management of Fine Spinners to establish the safety of taxpayers' money.
We have already proposed it. We are seeing whether we have any time, any opportunity within the limited time that we have to interact with the actual beneficiaries.
Report by Fred Kajibi for the news.